from within, plays down like it should last, play with that spirit, that fire, that sun pride that we have, keep everything on the field, believe in each other, believe in each other. 60 minutes, one play at a time, don't be out hustled, don't be out hit, play this game the way it's supposed to be, we're going to be winners, we're going to be champions.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Okanagan Sun TV. I'm Andy Holmes. I'm sitting here with Mac Weinsau, Matt Sherwater, Theo Magnus. Right now, we want to talk about the clubhouse, Kelowna, and the organization. Mac, what does this clubhouse mean to you, and why is it special?
It's special for me because last year was my last year, and I got to spend 6 years with the team, and I got to see the clubhouse kind of how it was when it was first built, and then after the unfortunate fire, how we rebuilt it, and the traditions made in the new clubhouse as well as the traditions in the old clubhouse. And it means a lot to me. It's a lot of family and a lot of guys that I've grown to become good friends with, and it's something I'll never forget.
Perfect. And Matt, you're from out of town. You're from a little bit of a colder area. You come to Kelowna. You know, Kelowna's got the beaches. It's got the ski hills. What's your favorite part about playing in a town like Kelowna?
Oh, I never have to play in snow. It's like middle of January right now, and there's no snow on the ground, so that's a bonus. Definitely doesn't ever get cold, so I like playing in the heat.
And Theo, you've been a part of this organization for a couple years now. What have you noticed about, in the organization of this team, and what do you appreciate most about it?
Definitely the family aspect. Everyone's really linked together. Definitely a really fun place to play. You know, you got 75 brothers on your team. It's just really great feeling to play in a type of team like this.
Perfect. So, what we're going to do is we're going to get the guys to give us a tour of the clubhouse, the area. Right now, the beautiful apple is under construction, only getting better. So, we won't focus on that right now. We'll try to pull up some older pictures to show you guys what this place really fills up to be. These stands that we're in right now, every single Saturday, Sunday, we have a home game. These places are filled up all the way across, the east bleachers are filled up. So, we really want to show those prospective players what this place can be like and show you why it's so special. So, we're going to get going.
All right, well, now let's go check out the locker room here. Come on. So as you see on the walls and on the roof, we got a bunch of people who played with us in the past. We got Pete's name up there, and there might be another couple names that you guys might hear that played in the CFL, so, or even the next level. So maybe just take a quick look around. We got three big TVs. We usually watch our film in sections, special teams, defense, offense, get to isolate which section we're looking at today. So I think these guys are just looking at the Rebels, who was a good competition last year. Here's all our cubicles. We got a little section for all your storage, for cleats and gear, and yeah. So you can see up above, we got some great air conditioning, because it definitely gets really hot out here in Kelowna. So after a hot, sweaty day of practice, all your gear is nice and dry due to the great circulation and the air conditioning in here. All right, so here, I'll hand off to Theo. Hey, Theo, come show them the bathroom. Make sure you wash your hands.
So these are our bathrooms. Like I said, nothing too big. Not for all of us, though. You have to probably get here a little bit earlier before practice if you want to get in one of these. Like I said, nothing too special. Here we got some showers. Showers after practice. Enough for everyone. And then this is where we keep all our cleaning supplies. Like I said, everyone takes turns cleaning every week. One group does the cleaning, so this is where we keep everything. And so, yeah, come here, grab a mop, clean up. Takes about 15, 20 minutes, and get to go home.
Now we're going to go check out the coach's room just around the corner here. Hey, coach, how's it going?
Doing well.
Good to see you.
Didn't expect to see you guys in here today.
Yeah, no, we're just checking things out. Got a couple questions for you that you're in here. What do you think about the new clubhouse?
Well, you can't complain. For junior football, this is a fantastic facility. We have all the amenities that a professional team has, so we have nothing to complain about.
And you were here, as a player. This is your second year as a coach. You started as a water boy, so you've kind of seen this team and this, this city, this organization, and the clubhouse grow. Explain what that means to you and kind of to the team and everybody that comes to play here.
Well, yeah, as you said there, I was a ball boy back in the day, and I still remember my first trip up the stairs, up into the clubhouse here, and all the sights and sounds and smells, and you know, it's it's a very good feeling to come back now, you know, in a different role and being the head coach after having been a player as well. Yeah, I've been in this place a long time, a lot of great memories in here, and a lot of tradition packed into this clubhouse walls.
Excellent. So, well, some won't keep you any longer from, you know, whatever you're doing in here. Not sure what coaches do, but probably nothing. Anyways, we're going to go check we're going to go check out the trainer's room. So, thanks again, Coach.
Yeah, you bet, Mac.
All right, next we're going to go check out the trainer's room. One good thing about the Sun, for motivation sakes, is at the beginning of the year when we start doing our, you know, our training and we do all our testing, we post all the numbers up, and you know, we're not shy about hiding any numbers or names or anything like that, and it's a little motivation. One of the things Coach McCall really pushes is to be better at the end of the year than you are at the beginning of the year, because that's when we're going to need to be the best. So this is a little motivation for us to always keep going, always keep pushing. But let's check out the trainer's room. This is our trainer's room. It's actually pretty nice. We got a lot going on. You know, we got three benches. Right now it looks like they're a little bit used for storage, but you know, this is used for taping. The cupboard's underneath here to store all our stuff. Over here we got beds. We got one of the best trainers that I know, that I've ever heard of. He's unbelievable. He's always here. He's dedicated to us, and you know, he gets a lot done on these. Soon enough, we're going to have our ice bath up and running. Once we get that going, I know nobody's ever going to leave this place. Ice machine for after practice, bumps and bruises. We try to keep everything healthy and, you know, as good as we can be. Yeah, that's basically our trainer's room.
So we're going to take us to the training room now. As you can see, we got a lot of equipment in here, guys. State-of-the-art equipment. It's very organized. We have a lot of volunteers who help us out every day. They'll help you out, get you through everything. Most players spend more time in here than they want to, but hey, that's the price they pay. Come back here. Most of the time, if you're here, you'll hear Bob Marley going on the CD player. It's a great atmosphere. You know, it takes a lot of work to get into one of these jerseys. We have them all hanging here. Get your name in one of these is definitely a great feeling. I remember the first time I saw my name on there. It was awesome. Like I said, we got a washer and dryer here. They take really good care of us. Tons of stuff. Towels for showers. Like, they definitely take care of you. Oh, the sewing machine? Well, I'm not exactly sure what goes on with the sewing machine. I'm assuming to put the names on, fix stuff up. But like I said, just one more piece of the puzzle. Makes this place work. Everything's here. We don't have to go. You know, everything works. You know, it's not nothing loose ends. It's all tied. Just a great place. They take real good care of you.
Now let's go check out the best part of this this organization. Let's see how sweet our whip is. Oh, here we go. Max staged up in his nice little Yamaha Sun Wagon. What do we got on here, Mac? What are these little sneakers? We got, looks like about 8-inch spinners with some Kenda rubber. And at night, we got a little underglow underneath it. We got some hydraulics back here. We have some subs underneath the seat, but the top secret.
This thing's great. When we got all our bags and stuff like that, we, you know, we have them in our storage, and when we got to get to the practice facility, and you know, we don't want guys carrying too much, so we throw it in the back of this bad boy, and it helps us transport, makes things quick.
So 0 to 60 in
2.4
minutes.
Yep.
Nice.
All right, we've showed you our training room. We've showed you our storage facility. We showed you our whip. And the clubhouse. I think it's time for us to get back to work and you guys to get out of here. Take it easy.
Again, thank you very much for joining us this evening. The Sun guys are gracious to show us their place. My name is Andy Holmes. You're watching Okanagan Sun TV. Tune in next week. We're going to have another great piece for you guys to check out.